What drives your boss to micromanage? Primarily, three things. One, distrust, that is, fear of your intentions. Two, fear of having projects end badly. And three, the boss's own insecurity and his or her ability to manage projects and relationships. There's six very practical ways to deal with a micromanager, to build trust and increase skill in this area. I'm going to mention three of those ways here. And hey, if you think you yourself might be that micromanager, then these tips will maybe help you overcome that habit. First, practice direct communication. State directly what you need or want more of or less of in your work relationships or on a specific assigned project. No hinting. Be very explicit. Distrust comes from faulty assumptions about another person's intentions. Don't leave your boss guessing about why you did or didn't attend a specific meeting. Don't leave the boss guessing about why you did or didn't even tell them about the meeting. Just be forthcoming with any specific information that you think the boss would need to know. Don't make them uneasy, fearful, skeptical, or distrusting. And then ask questions. Listen carefully before you draw conclusions about the boss's intentions, motive, or assumptions. Verify those conclusions. Never leave a conversation wondering why, wondering about motives or hidden agendas or hidden meanings. Just ask. Ask explicitly in a calm, non-accusatory tone. And consider tone and phrasing extremely important. And most important, take the boss's answer at face value. And three, in understanding your micromanager boss, put things in writing for reference. Ask for clarifications and approvals in writing so that both of you have a clear recall of what was said and what was not said. But, and this is very important, but be careful not to use the written document to trap each other. That goes back to intention. Consider it as a basis for investigating and discussing how things got off track, when that occasionally will happen. You'll both become aware of communication pitfalls in the relationship, snafus that will decrease as this writing for reference practice continues. For three additional tips on how to stop a micromanager, listen to How to Stop a Micromanager, Part 2.